previous section, the emphasis was on preventing reading and writing problems. In this section, the aim is to offer suggestions for dealing with children who transfer to a school at a later date and who are poor at reading and writing. The first thing is to test the children on a standardised reading and spelling test in order to obtain the reading and spelling age of each child. I think it is sensible to do this for all children who transfer from other schools. Knowing the reading and spelling age of the child is useful and helps the teacher to provide reading books and spelling challenges appropriate for their ability. However, the main interest is to identify the children in need of support so that intervention teaching can quickly be organised. If a child seems particularly intelligent, then bear in mind that their results should be well above average. Now, the children who score below their chronological age on reading tests are nearly always poor at decoding. Sometimes there is a comprehension problem as well. It makes sense to sort the decoding problems out first and then to concentrate more on comprehension. Usually when the children can read the words easily, then they tend to understand them. And if they don't, then give them simpler text to read. Comprehension improves through speaking, listening and reading. This section specifically sets out to deal with the decoding and encoding problems. There are many standardised reading tests on the market. Group reading tests are particularly good for testing several children, or in fact a whole class, at the same time. It saves a great deal of time. And usually the tests consist of about 30 sentences, like these. Now, in each sentence, there is a word missing, and the children have to choose the word that fits into the sentence from a selection of 5 or 6 words underneath, and then put a ring round it. So here we'll have, the boy slept in a bunk, now is it Bill, big, bed, bad, badger, best. And the child has to choose the one that fits in there, which of course is bed. And then there, something took them through the mountains. What is it? Jigsaw, treasure, jumble, tent, journey, happy. And of course there is journey. The sentences start with simple ones and then gradually become more complicated. There is an element of comprehension involved in these tests, as well as word reading. And these tests provide a reading age, a quotient, or both. Now, with quotients, a child who scores 100 is exactly average. But then between 90 and 110 is an overall average. Below 90 is below average, and above 110 is above average. Now, from my experience, the children scoring above 100 are really good readers who go on to do well in their secondary education. And the children scoring between 90 and 100 are a slight cause for concern, even though they are generally considered in the average in the wider sense. They need watching. But scores between 70 and 90 are a sign of definite problems and support should be provided. Now, any child scoring below 70 is truly an extremely poor reader. In fact, they can hardly read at all. These single word reading tests have individual words that the children are expected to read and they become progressively harder, like these. Here we are, we start simple and then gradually get more complicated. There is no context, so it is impossible to deduce the word. It is a quick and easy test to administer, but only one child can be tested at a time. Most spelling tests are single word tests. Each word is dictated and the children write it down. Usually more than 30 words are tested. Sometimes sentences are provided and the child has to spell the missing word. Nowadays there are online tests which are very useful too. In fact, there are many different types of standardised tests. I've just mentioned a few of them. Ideally, it is sensible to select tests that provide a reading age and a spelling age. Most people, especially parents, find it easier to understand results in ages rather than quotients or percentiles. Teachers are usually aware when a child is not reading or spelling well enough. The tests provide a useful evidence of just how far a child is behind. But what most of the tests do not do is identify why the child is having problems and what must be done to rectify it. Advice about this is provided later. Sometimes it is necessary for one-to-one intervention, especially if the child has failed for several years and has a poor attitude. A quick one-to-one crash course in their new school can be exceedingly effective. And once the child starts to understand that reading and writing is a code and that all they have to do is to learn the missing bits, then their attitude often changes from negative to positive. Usually, it is more difficult to rectify the problems if the children are older than 7. They often have big chips on their shoulders. They have been struggling and failing for a long time and feel understandably resentful. Nearly always, they think the fault is with them and that they are not clever enough. Now, this we know is just not true. Somewhere along the line, the teaching has gone wrong and there has been insufficient support. So, what are the best ways of dealing with these children? In my view, I think it is best to be honest with the children and tell them the results of their reading and spelling tests. And then explain that you're going to assess their code knowledge to find out why it is so difficult for them and what will be done to sort the difficulties out. Nearly always the problem is that the children do not know enough letter sounds and are weak at blending and segmenting.